United program created for the Rio Grande Oil Company.
Takes an apartment.
of Mrs. Stephen Howard. He is showing it to her for the first time.
Well, kitten, here you are, your little love nest. How do you like it?
Oh, Bill, it's darling.
Suits you okay, Mrs. Kelly?
That's the part I don't like. Hiding from people about it. Using a false name.
Well, pretty soon it'll be Mrs. Dan Kelly. Or would you rather be known as Mrs. Bull Kelly?
I don't care so long as everybody knows that I belong to you.
That's the way I like to hear you talk, kitten.
Oh, but a small picture of you.
Yeah, I put that there for you. See, I wrote on it.
To my fuzzy little kitten, with all my love. Bull. Oh, darling, Bull. You look fierce crouching like that with those wicked gloves on.
I had more hair then.
I like your hair better now. Well, it's trim in the front there. Gives you a distinguished look.
Well, no use crying for the past. Nothing will bring that back.
I don't want anything to bring back the past. And all those women you loved once.
Oh, I never loved anyone like I love you.
If I could only be sure.
On my honor.
You told the others the same thing.
I had never known you then.
Oh, Bull, please. Please never love anyone else.
I won't. You're the medicine I need for what ails me. You won't fall for anyone, will you?
How could I? Not when I have you. You with your strong, sweet body. I'll never take my eyes off this picture when you're away from me. I'll just sit and look at you and think about you and your muscles of steel. Oh, my darling. Oh, darling. I married him because I felt sorry for him. I was his stenographer, and he seemed so helpless. As though he needed someone. And he leaned on me so. But it just couldn't work. May and December never do. And then you came along. And that was the biggest day of my life. You did things to me, Bull. The first time I set my eyes on you, I went all weak inside. And I've been that way ever since. I love you, Bull.
I love you,
Bull.
I love you, kitten. I love you, kitten.
For a long time, haven't we?
Yes.
And I've always been a friend, haven't I? Maybe even your best friend.
Hmm?
Maybe even your best friend.
Hmm? Oh, you know you're my best friend, Anna.
All right. And that's the reason I hate to see you making a fool of yourself.
What do you mean?
You know what I mean. Bull Kelly.
I don't see how he can send you.
He doesn't, excepting as how he may harm you.
Harm me?
Yes. Drag you down, treating you, make you something low.
Stop. I won't stand you talking about him like that. I've had enough.
Very well.
Anna, you are my friend, and I love you dearly. I don't want to fight with you, but I will if you say another word about him. He's my man, and I love him more than anything in the world.
All right, Roberta, if you can't stop my opinions, and I think you're being a plain, ungrounded fool.
Anna, wait!
Well, then, what's the matter?
Oh, it's Anna. She was just here.
What?
No. She was just here.
Well, what of it? What did she do to upset you like this?
She was trying to talk about you.
Oh, she was she?
Yes. She was trying to persuade me.
Why doesn't she mind her own business?
That's what I told her. I wouldn't listen to the things she was trying to say.
Well, I'll tell her, and she'll stay told. I'll tie that long tongue of hers into a knot. I'll show her a thing or two.
No, please. Don't do anything about it. Just forget it. There's trouble enough already.
But Cole doesn't forget it. That evening, she is picketing the entrance of Anna Benson's house when she comes home from work. Just a minute, Mr. Simpson.
Yes?
Do you know me?
Why, it's so dark here, I can't... Say, yes, you're Bill Kelly, aren't you?
Right. How well do you know me?
Well, we've met, that's about all.
Right. You don't know me at all, then, really, do you?
Why, no. No, I guess I don't.
All right, then. Why don't you keep that big mouth of yours closed and that big nose of yours out of other people's business?
Why, I don't...
You heard me. I don't want you shooting off your face to Roberta anymore, enough, Detner. You might as well get this straight. Roberta and I are getting married just as soon as her divorce is final. And nothing you or old man Thompson or your husband or anybody else can do about it can stop us. And if you try, it's just going to be too bad for you and everybody else concerned. Good night, Mrs. Benson.
Nothing else for an hour.
Don't you think she's being foolish, Tom?
Well, frankly, yes. Look here, Roberta. What you do with your life now is your own business. I think I've made a liberal settlement.
Of course you have, Thomas. I shall always regard you as a friend. You know that.
Yes, of course. Well, as I said before, I hate to see you throw away your money on a good-for-nothing like this Kelly fellow.
He isn't a good for nothing. I'm not going to throw my money away on him. We have plans, all sorts of plans.
Look here, Roberta. You know the reputation of this man?
Well, yes, of course I do, Mr. Benson.
Four wives already. Heaven knows
how. How do you know, after he's run through your money, that you won't go the way of the other four?
But I...
I tell you, Roberta, you're playing with dynamite. I've been around, and I know.
Oh, I don't know what to do.
Be smart. Tell him it's all off. Tell him you're sorry, but you've made a big mistake.
Oh, Mr. Denton, do you really think that's the wise thing to do?
Of course I do.
Certainly it is. Roberta, I no longer have any interest in you, save as a friend. I'm advising you as a friend. We're all advising you as friends.
Well, if you think that's the best thing to do, I'll tell him. I'll tell him tonight.
And so that night, Roberta Thompson awaits Bull Kelly in her apartment. Evening comes and goes as midnight approaches. Still, he has not arrived. Finally, a few minutes after 12 o'clock.
Hello, Mr. Simpson. You've been waiting long, but...
A little while.
You got a kiss for it?
Oh. You've been drinking, bro.
Yeah, I had a few. Brought a pint home. Here, you want a swig?
No, thanks.
Okay. Say, what's the matter with you?
Nothing.
Sure there is. You're like an iceberg. Come on, thaw out. Daddy's home.
Sit down, bro. I've got to talk to you.
Yeah? What's up?
Well, it hard to say. I don't know where to begin. You see...
So what is this?
You and I are through, Bull. That's all.
What? What did you say?
We're through. It's all over.
Oh, but Skippin', darling, you can't do this. You can't walk out on me like this. You can't. I'll let you.
Don't think it's been easy for me to say, Bull. It isn't. But I've got it all over. Back and forth and up and down. And that's the only answer you get.
Yeah, but why? What's the matter? What have I done?
Nothing. Oh, there's no use talking about it anymore. I'm afraid to go on.
What's the matter? Don't you love me anymore?
Yes, that's it. I don't love you anymore. I don't love you as much as I thought I did.
Oh, but Jessie, you don't mean that. You can't.
Yes, there it is. And now that you've heard it, I might as well go. I waited all evening to tell you, and I've said it, so I'll go now.
Well, where are you going?
I don't know.
That's your husband. Why didn't I think about that? You've been talking to him and that Benson couple. Yeah, they've been putting ideas into your head, ain't they?
No, but I swear it.
You're lying.
I figured this out for myself.
You're lying in your teeth, and you know it.
No, I'm not, Bill. On the level, I'm not. I'm going now.
Oh, no, you're not. You're staying right here.
Let me out, Bill. There's no use talking anymore. We're through, and I want to go now.
There's no sense in being in a hurry, kitten.
What are you going to do with that gun?
Well, I don't know yet.
Put it away, Bull. Put it down. It makes me nervous.
Why? If your conscience was clear, a little toy like this wouldn't bother you.
Stop. Stop, Bull. Don't bother me like that.
All right. Come clean. Those pals and that ex-husband of yours put you up to this, didn't they?
No, I swear it. No.
You're lying.
No, I'm not. I'm telling you the truth.
They put you up to this and you know it. Now, are you going through with it or are you going to stick with me and marry me like we planned?
I wouldn't marry you now for anything. You can't frighten me. You can't scare me. I hate you now.
Oh, you're walking out. Is that the straight of it?
Yes.
Get back.
down here right away. Use some excuse, any excuse, but don't tell him I'm here.
But Mr. Kelly...
Get going. Meanwhile, at the apartment house, the Negro porter, cleaning up the room, makes a discovery.
And after just finishing Mrs. Howard's apartment, David, you can bring that rubbish in the back.
Yes, I sure will. Yes. Mrs. Howard, ma'am, is you there? Well, I guess she ain't.
Thompson at the restaurant, Kelly has held up everyone who comes in and forced the men to take off their pants and shoes.
Now, look here. You'll get my money, but
Sarah,
I won't.
Take off those trousers.
I won't.
Oh, Mr. Kelly, that vase was worth $5.
And the next time I won't throw vases, it'll be a bullet. Now, take off them pants.
$5 vases, he told.
Miss Berwyn, phone up Benson and his wife and tell him to come up here. Tell him Thompson wants to see him. I might as well get all the victims together.
But Mr. Kelly...
Here's your clothes.
Look here, can't you let my wife and me out of here? I don't know what this is all about. We just dropped in for a fight to eat. We don't want any bad publicity.
You don't look like a bad guy to me. Decent. Not like most of the people around here. I can't let you out until I finish up, but I tell you what I will let you do. You move over on the other side of the room beside your wife. It'll be safer. I may start shooting over here any minute.
Yes, Mr. Thompson would like to see you. Why, he can't come to the phone right now. He's busy. Yes, he's busy with a customer. Thank you.
They're coming?
Yes, they said they'd be here right away.
Good. Ah, oh, another customer. You got a gun, mister?
Say, what is this?
Call it what you like. You got a gun?
Why, no.
Got any money?
Why, yes, a little.
Give it here.
I will not. Look here, what's the big idea?
Well, that's just a sample. Now, give me your money and take off your trousers.
Well, now, look here, my man.
Want some more? Take them off. Let's have the dough. There. That's more like it. Let's see. Not bad. More than 120 bucks and a nice diamond. Say, buddy, was it you said you didn't have any dough?
Yeah.
Well, here's a buck for you.
Hey.
Ah, here they come, my friends the Bensons. What's the matter with them? They looked in and they turned around and beat it.
Yeah, I'd be the fool if I'd have seen that cannon in your hand.
Oh, well. I'll tend to them after I fix Thompson.
Look here, can't I put my trousers on my lap?
No.
But there's a lady over there.
Can't help it. You birds are going to stay right here. How soon will Thompson be here, Miss Berman?
Why, he ought to be here any minute.
Good. I'm going to make a break for it.
Oh, don't you mess with all of it.
I think I can beat a bullet to that door.
Oh, no, you don't. Well, I'll go out and get the other two anyway. Your name, Benson?
Oh, yes. What do you want?
Where's Mrs. Benson? Oh, well, there you are. Well, this is for trying to interfere in my private affairs.
Officer, officer, a man just shot three people down the street.
Where?
There he goes now, running up Alvarado.
Hey, you in the car. Follow that guy up Alvarado.
Right. Hop on.
Got him. Pull up here. Drop that gun, you, or I'll drill you. Okay. I get you. You got
me. Kelly claimed that Mrs. Thompson killed herself, but police investigators proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that Kelly killed her. Fortunately, the persons struck down by Kelly's bullets were not seriously wounded. He was sent to San Quentin for a maximum sentence of 20 years on charges of manslaughter and assault with a deadly weapon.
Thank you, Chief Davis. Ladies and gentlemen, whenever you hear the scream of a siren, whenever you see a police car, fire engine, or motorcycle roar by, let it remind you that Rio Grande cracked gasoline powers more of these emergency cars than does any other brand. Keen buyers for city and other governmental units carefully analyzed and tested all gasolines on the market. And during the year 1935, they purchased 4,500,000 gallons of Rio Grande cracked gasoline because, in their expert opinion, it gave greater speed, power, and more economical performance. You can have the same performance in your own car at no extra cost if you will drive into the independent Rio Grande service station near you and treat your car to Rio Grande cracked gasoline. Also, ask for a free copy of the Calling All Cars News and read how you may get a complete junior detective outfit free of charge for the boys and girls in your family.
Broadcast 114. Bill Kelly is now in custody. That's all. Rolls and
see the radio cast of Calling All Cars at your local theater in person? Star players on this broadcast are now touring the theaters, dramatizing the most thrilling show ever broadcast, The Human Bomb. Ask your local theater manager when the cast of Calling All Cars will make a personal appearance on his stage.